Ako si Franco Daza.
At ako si Tours Daza.
And today, we are going to show you all about our family business, which is Casa Daza by Chef Sandy. At ipapakita namin sa inyo one of our many products, which will be
the empanada. We'll be showing you guys yung iba-ibang mga flavors, yung staff na nandito, the ones who are making the empanada, as well as yung procedure sa pagkagawa ng empanada. So, we'll be checking all those out today.
Correct. So, stay tuned and we will show you what it takes to run our family business, Casa Daza by Chef Sandy.
Okay guys, so andito kami ngayon sa labas ng commissary namin. And we're about to show you guys what goes on inside.
Papakilala namin sa inyo ang head chef namin, si Bernard Canlas. Now, he's been with the family for many years. And siya yung nagsispearhead and nagli-lead in terms of making the empanadas, building the team, and sa lahat ng mga procedures namin. So we will introduce him to you and he will give us a quick tour. Let's go! Guys, ito si Bernard Canlas, siya yung head chef namin. And he will be giving us a quick tour of the empanadas. Okay, let's go.
Yes sir, pasok po kaya.
Okay, pasok.
Dito na kami nag-start para mapagmasak po ng panada po. And then, after nandito na po, susunod na po lang dito, plating po. Hindi, ginagamit tayo pang plating. Kakagawa po kami ng 350 pieces.
Sa isang?
Isang piece po, isang plate.
Wow, 350 pieces.
Okay. Nakapag-provide po kami ng 1-6 pieces.
1-6 pieces?
Oh, okay. Love na.
Tapos sa ilang mga stalls namin yan?
Ay, meron po kami 12 na kiosk po.
12 kiosk? Ah, okay.
Everyday po yan, doon pwede deliver lahat ng mga nagagawa po ng mga.
So fresh lahat, everyday.
Yung empanada natin para po pang pasarap sa ating pong... Hello guys!
Bro, sa isang araw, ilan kaya yung nagagawa mo dito?
Ito maka...
A million?
Hindi. Hindi na ako pa. Maka 1-3, 1-4 po isang araw magawa namin lahat dito.
Wow!
Hello po!
Nung nilalagay mo?
Raisin po.
Raisin.
Para sweet.
Para sweet.
One of my closest friends dito sa empanada, siya din ang second in command. Kano katagal na tayong magkaibigan? Nagkakilala tayo.
Bata to pa.
Oo.
Nagkakilala na kami.
8 years old pa lang ata ako. Friends na kami ni Toto. So,
wow.
So yun. Sige to, maraming salamat ha. Thank you. So guys, ito again ulit. Ito ang hilaw na empanadas. We will be showing you kung ano yung itsura ng finished product.
Yes, and the empanada, pag may red dot, ibig sabihin nun, this is chicken flavor. Pag walang red dot,
It's beef. So sa pagfa-fry, busy pa siya eh.
As you guys remember, this is Bernard, ang Bernard. Head chef namin dito sa Casa Dasa Empanada. So Bernard, kaka-fry lang natin ng empanadas. Pakita natin please sa mga viewers kung ano yung itsura ng fried empanada.
Yes. Wow!
Wala po siya.
Yun.
So Bernard, para sa mga viewers namin, kung pwedeng pakiulit, ano yung mga current flavors natin dito sa Casa Dasa Empanada?
Meron na po kaming original empanada and then chicken and kumba.
Ayun, so ito na guys, ito yung final product ng empanada, yung chicken flavor. 68 pesos siya per piece or 400 pesos per box. So guys, be sure if you want to order, you can check us out sa Facebook, nakalagay dito. Casa Dasa by Chef Sandy sa Facebook.
That is correct. PM is key. Make sure you order through direct message, personal message, not on post.
Sa amin nung nawalan na kami ng pasok, so nakikipag-communicate naman sa amin sila mong media, pinadalang kami ng dalawang pasok. Isang pasok, binigay sa amin ng isang buo, kahit 7 days lang yung pasok namin. And then yung second naman na pasok, kahit wala kaming pasok, binigay nila sa amin ng food. Siyempre po, yun nung mga panahon wala kaming income, nagbigay rin sila ng mga cash advance sa amin. So kahit papano na wala naman kami ng pasok, hindi kami natakot na ay wala na kami papano kami sa susunod na araw kasi alam namin na sinusuportahan, tinutulungan pa rin kami ng Casa Dasa.
Hi everyone, we're your starpreneurs. I'm Touris Dasa.
And I'm Franco Dasa.
So Kuya, you actually worked in Casa Dasa. So Kuya, ano yung pinagkaiba sa Casa Dasa since the start of the quarantine?
Compared to after before. Before and after. I think yung malaking pinagkaiba ng operations namin is definitely nagsara yung sit-down restaurant namin. It's closed indefinitely, hindi naman siya permanently closed. Malaki talaga yung difference now. You know, we're still blessed that we still have customers and consumers for the empanada business. And it's running well. Actually, parang more or less the same. If not, by a little lang we are not hitting the same numbers as we were before. Pero in terms of the empanada business, okay naman siya.
Was there anything that Casa Dasa did para makope sila sa nangyari dahil sa pandemic?
In terms of marketing, you know, my cousin, one of the GMs, Ara Vidanes, she's fantastic.
Hello,
hey Ara, she's fantastic in marketing. And we didn't make any drastic changes, none that I noticed, but as in, thank God talaga that, you know, there was a little bit of a lull in sales because of the pandemic. Pero when things came back to normal, the sales more or less for the empanadas came back to normal. But there weren't any extra initiatives. I think we were more naka-focus kami sa safety ng staff namin tsaka sa safety ng consumer. So it's time for me to ask Arturo some questions regarding our family business. Arturo, what is it do we have here?
Well, this is it we have here.
I know.
We have some tinapa and tuyo. So guys, since Franco's more focused sa empanada, ito naman yung side project ko. I've been making these gourmet bottles of tuyo and tinapa. And they're made with extra virgin olive oil. So they're healthier than your average tuyo and tinapa. I ordered these fish all the way from, I think it's Bataan. Mm-hmm. And they come in, tapos, ayun, hinihimay ko sila, I take out the skin. You have to fry it in oil beforehand and then debone. And yeah, we have a secret recipe for these guys, mm-hmm. which my dad gave to me. And then we bottled them. Actually, one of my first investments that I made when I got my paycheck, thank you, Star Magic, I actually bought a vacuum sealer machine, which I used to bottle these. So it makes it last for up to 1 to 2 years. So yeah, these are our gourmet tuyo and tinapa, one of our many Casa Dasa products. So in the future, we plan to expand, mm-hmm. maybe sell some bagaong, what we're planning as well, mm-hmm. maybe other fish products.
Who knows? Who knows what our dad is going to come up with? That's it mm-hmm. for this episode of Starpreneurs. Guys, thank you so much. Again, don't forget, if you want to order any empanadas, please log on to Facebook and go to www.facebook.com/casadasabychefsandy and PM. For PM is the key.
So guys, you can order these. Just check out. Well, actually, I actually have some of the bottles left in our restaurants. In Rockwell, in Wooden Spoon, so you guys can ask there. But if that's far from you, you guys can always just message me, slide in those DMs, and we'll connect. I'd like to take this opportunity to remind you guys to always support local, always support Philippine cuisine, because Philippine cuisine is honestly one of the tastiest and one of the most diverse cuisines. So yeah, we want to promote Philippine cuisine, something our dads always taught us, to be proud of our cuisine and always be willing to share it with others. Mm-hmm. And if it tastes good to you, serve it.
Serve it.
What's up guys? Kami po ang tatambay sa Star Magic Lounge
sa Kumu ngayong Biyernes.
Kasama sa hashtag CK, Maru, Jimboy at Tom.
At i-follow niyo po ang Star Magic Pills.
Yes, and we hope that we will have you on